Lisa Munoz has won cash and prizes totaling $72,551. Today, one of our contestants could win a brass band, a gold watch, an oriental cabinet, or a trip to Norway, and continue a journey towards a fortune in cash and prizes, including this BMW. $50,000 in cash. In total, over $100,000 on Sale of the Century. And now, here's the star of our show, Jim Curry.
Thank you. Delighted to have you with us. Thank you. We're very happy to have you with us for Sale of the Century today, and you picked a great day to join us. A very, very exciting half hour in front of us because our champion has cleared all of the prizes off of the winner's board. 10 great prizes, including a great trip, 2 sports cars, $10,000 in cash, $3,000 in cash. She has chosen to risk those prizes in order to try to add the bonus. If she loses today, she would lose all 10 of those prizes. If she wins, she gets all 10 prizes plus an additional $50,000. So a lot to shoot for Lisa Munoz. Hello, Lisa.
Hi, Jim.
Had a little time to think about it. Have you had any regrets about making the decision to go for that additional $50,000?
None at all, Jim.
No? You're ready?
I'm very excited and very happy to be here.
I can only say good luck to you. And here to introduce the challengers is Summer Bartholomew. Hello, Summer.
Hi. How are you?
Well, she's tough, but I know you have some tough. I know. Everybody's been very nervous backstage. Who did you bring?
He wants to go into training from Chula Vista, California. Say hi to Clay Kemper.
Hello there, Clay.
And she's an escape artist from Huntington Beach, California. Let's welcome Cindy Bowden.
Hi there, Cindy. Summer, we'll see you later with some bargains. Thank you. Let's get acquainted with these challengers here. Cindy, you are an escape artist?
Yes, Jim. I love to visit exotic places and meet different people through books.
Oh, I see. So you escape into your imagination.
Yes.
That sounds nice. Nice to have you here. Clay, you want to go into training? I can't imagine going back into the Army. What's this mean?
Well, not actually, Jim. My secret ambition is to travel all the exotic trains of the world, like the Orient Express and the Trans-Siberian Railway and the trains in Australia and New Zealand.
Oh, I would like to join you. That's one of the things I enjoy as well, trains. Nice to have you here. Good luck to all three of you. We'll start you all off with $20 and get into the match with us. What fictional character has been portrayed on film by David Niven, George Lazenby, Lisa?
James Bond.
And Roger Moore and Sean Connery. James Bond it is. $5 for the correct answer. Lisa goes to 25. Standing only 5'4", Dolly's husband, Lisa?
Mickey Rooney.
Now, he did a lot of things, but he was never president. Dolly's husband was our shortest U.S. president. James Madison was only 5'4", and you lose 5 for the incorrect answer, back down to 20. Ethel Merman once said, most people think I have nice gams. Click Clay.
Legs.
That's what gams are, and Clay goes into the lead by a question. According to the first line of Elizabeth Barrett Browning's poem, How Do I Love Thee, Lisa?
Let me count the ways.
You got it, then you're in a tie with Clay at 25. When dressing for a formal affair, on what part of his body would a man wear his cummerbund? Lisa.
Around his waist.
You are right. Lisa goes into the lead by a question. Yes. Well, she's closing in on a lot, but of course, along the way, if you're in the lead when an instant bargain comes up, you have the opportunity to buy. Lisa, a one-question lead over Clay. How about this?
Lisa, you can add a little focus to your life with this 13-inch portable color television featuring automatic fine-tuning, 100% micro-condensed circuitry, and UHF channel dialing from Sharp. And it's normally priced at $390, but today on Sale of the Century, yours for only $5.
Well, I know you have a small TV that you want, but this is a larger one. And Lisa, forget about the over $50,000 in prizes that you're risking in cash. Forget about the $50,000 you're trying to win. Think about each little thing as it comes along. $390 for a color TV. Here it's only $5. You'd be in a tie with Clay, and I want to help you. I'll help you to the tune of, for just $5, one, two, three, four, $500 in cash right off the bat. Color TV, $500 in cash for just $5. Going once.
I don't know, Jim.
Going twice. And no sale. not buying, even with that much cash. One question lead over Clay. All she's got to do is win by $1, but she's got to win. Name the actress who won an Oscar for her electrifying performance of Sally Bowes in the movie Cabaret. Lisa.
Liza Minnelli.
Liza Minnelli it is, as Lisa just keeps everyone to the buzzer. $10 lead. In Roman numerals, what number is represented by the letter D? Cindy.
50.
No. 500. 500. Sorry about that, Cindy. You lose 5 for the incorrect answer, down to 15. In fiction, what profession is held in common by characters named Philo Vance and Philip Marlowe? Lisa?
Detective.
Detectives is right, as Lisa beats Clay to the buzzer and goes to 40. Part of the fame game. And those dollars up there on the fame game board could be the difference in this most important match. $10 money card up there and a lot of information about a famous thing. I am the oldest musical instrument of my kind. According to the Bible, I was invented by Jubal, and my earliest play.
Zither.
Incorrect. Out of the rest of the question, we will clear it. Continue for Cindy and Lisa. My earliest version had only 1 or 2 octaves. In 1720, a pedal attachment greatly improved me. Cindy.
A piano?
No. Oh, Lisa, great break. You've got the rest of the question all to yourself. Today, my most common version is a large instrument that rests on the floor and is held between the legs of the player. My many strings are plucked with the fingers and thumbs, a technique that was once demonstrated by the Marx brother with the blonde wig. I'm the national symbol of Ireland. I am...
Cello?
No. Ooh, audience, you know?
A harp!
A harp. So no one gets a crack at it, but however, we will tempt you a little bit. We'll show you where that $10 money card is.
Behind the tree.
It's going to stay there, and we'll add another one. So the next fame game, there'll be 2 of them to shoot for. Lisa couldn't take advantage of that break. We'll be right back.
No more...
Lisa Munoz taking a big risk for $50,000 in cash, and she has the lead. Lisa at 40, Clay at 25, Cindy at 15. What are you doing to your meat if you soak it in a mixture of vinegar? Lisa?
Marinate.
Oil, spices, and herbs before cooking. Marinate is exactly what it is. And again, Lisa's just beating Clay to the buzzer there. She's got a $20 lead. In what country would we find one of the world's most beautiful and costly tombs, the Taj Mahal? Lisa?
India.
India's right, Lisa, to 50. From the Latin word meaning empty, what do we call a space with no matter in it? Clay.
Void.
No. Oh, this time you beat it to the buzzer at the wrong time. No, a vacuum is what that is. And Clay loses 5 down to 20. After World War I, an international association of countries was formed called the League of... Clay?
Nations.
You got that 5 right back and back to 25, yes. But it is Lisa with a $25 lead and an instant bargain coming up. And this is something you haven't won. Now, remember, Lisa, of course, everything you pick up along the way is not at risk. How about this?
Oh, Lisa, hang on to your heart because you're off on a trip to beautiful San Francisco. We'll fly you and a friend from Los Angeles for a 3-day stay in the city by the bay where you'll enjoy the hospitality of Travelodge at the Wharf, walking distance to Fisherman's Wharf, a cable ride to Chinatown and Union Square, beautiful panoramic views and luxury accommodations furnished by Travelodge at the Wharf, and it's normally priced at $1,106, but today on sale of the century, it's yours for only $10.
Oh, is that great? You have not won a trip to San Francisco, right?
This is true, Jim.
You would enjoy a trip to San Francisco, I think, wouldn't you?
Oh, I love Tony Bennett.
Oh, good. You... Well, if you'd like to buy some of his records, I'll give you a chance to get some of his collector item versions of I Left My Heart in San Francisco. It costs you $10 for the $1,106 trip to San Francisco. You would still have a 3-question lead over Clay. You've been beating him to the buzzer. If you continue doing that, you're $50,000 richer.
Yeah?
If you go to San Francisco for $10, I will throw in for collector item records $1,000 in cash.
Ooh. Jim.
That's an over $2,000 trip for just 10 bucks. You'd still have a $15 lead. Going once, going twice, and no sale. Not buying. Hanging on to the $25 lead. Large fangs that resemble long curved swords is how this prehistoric tiger got its name. Clay.
Cheetah.
Nope. No, like swords, saber-toothed tiger, prehistoric, and Clay loses 5. What phrase was coined by Winston Churchill to describe the political barrier between the Soviet bloc nations and the rest? Lisa?
Iron Curtain.
The rest of the world? Yes, it was Churchill who said it. Iron Curtain is right. Lisa to 55. On the coast of what European country can you now peacefully visit the D-Day beaches dubbed Omaha, Lisa?
France.
Utah and Juno, and they're all in France, and Lisa to 60. In science, name is given to the type of paper that indicates whether a solution, Lisa?
Litmus.
Is acid or alkaline? You are right. It is litmus. From the Latin meaning going on foot comes this word to describe someone who's walking. Lisa.
Pedestrian.
Pedestrian is right. Lisa with a big segment goes to 70. Yeah. Talking about being a pedestrian, I have a definitive definition about being a pedestrian from a father's perspective. A pedestrian is a man with two cars and two teenage children. We'll be right back. Lisa Munoz with a strong segment that last one. She stretched her lead out a bit. She has a $50 lead right now over Clay. Back to the fame game and a $15 money card added to the board. This time we look for a famous thing. I am an animal that lives in the savannas south of the Sahara Desert. A large male of my species weighs about 2,000 pounds. Like a cow, I have a cud and eat leaves, twigs. Cindy.
A camel.
Incorrect. Out of the rest of the question, we'll clear it. Continue for Clay and Lisa. Like a cow, I have a cud and eat leaves, twigs, and fruit. Lisa.
A llama?
No. Ooh, Clay, this time you've got the rest of the question to yourself. I usually sleep standing up. My coat has patch-like markings and two bony horn-like bumps project from my skull. To drink, I must spread my forelegs apart and lower my head to the water. Due to my long legs and very long neck, I am the tallest of all animals. I am, Clay?
A giraffe.
A giraffe is right. This time you can take advantage of it, and you did. Yeah, I would have been thrown by the fact that a giraffe is about 2,000 pounds. That was interesting. $15 money card where, Summer?
Behind the one.
Two of them, and if you're going to catch her, Clay, you might need one, so we lock into your buzzer now with that light. Good luck. Lands on number six. What do we have for him?
A mantle clock. Michael C. Fina's 1810 Americana mantle clock. With Westminster quarter hour striking movement in a genuine walnut hand rubbed case. Furnished by the Michael C. Fina Company.
All right, that's over $400. And incidentally, you are going to get a couple of dollars because our judge signaled me during the break there that the answer, you said a void, and we were looking for the answer, a vacuum. They looked it up in the book, and they do come from the same root. So you were going to get an additional $10 added to your score. The five we took away, plus five for the correct answer. And you go to $30 on that. And in a match this important, I must congratulate our judge on checking in right now. Better now than later. It is Lisa at 70, Clay at 30, Cindy at 15. Name the man who endowed the awards that were first bestowed in 1917 by the Columbia University School of Journalism. No idea? No. The Pulitzer Prizes, Joseph Pulitzer. No one wanted to try that. What is the name of the crime in which a person at a judicial proceeding swears to tell the truth? Lisa?
Perjury.
And then deliberately lies. You are right. Perjury it is. Lisa to 75. In the 80s, Disney Studios re-released this 1940 animated film classic, which combines colorful artwork with classical music. Cindy?
Fantasia.
There you go. Now you're back on the plus side. Five for Cindy going to 20. But an instant bargain, and Lisa, I will tell you, you have a $45 lead and the opportunity to buy this.
Lisa, this instant bargain will fit into your game plan for your home. Regal's Oak Game Table. Simply remove the top for bumper pool, replace the top for poker, or flip the top for dining. Complemented with four tavern chairs, furnished by Regal Manufacturing Company. And it's normally priced at $1,651. But today on Sale of the Century, it's yours for only $15.
That's very nice. And Lisa, you love playing pool, right?
Yes,
and
I do.
You want a pool table?
Yes,
this would go terrific in a game room with the pool table. $1,651. Here it costs $15. Now, I want to lay it all out for you, Lisa, because it's your decision. You have a $45 lead. If you bought this for $15, you would still have a big lead. It would be a $30 lead. Of course, there's a $25 money card going up on the board with
That's
the third
true.
And final fame game. And there is also the speed round. I'm coming to see you. But a $30 lead might be all you need to make $50,000. So I will give you that table, $1,651 worth, for just $15. And I will throw in, would you like to count it?
Okay.
Okay.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, $1,500.
That's right. The table, $1,500 for 15 bucks, but your lead would be cut to $30.
Ooh,
going once, going twice, and no sale. We'll be back. If she hangs on, she's $50,000 richer. She wants the biggest edge possible as we get down to the wire. She's got the lead, 75 for Lisa, 30 for Clay, Cindy has 20. Which U.S. president was paid tribute in James Whitmore's one-man show? Lisa?
Truman?
Give him hell, Harry. You are right. It is Truman. Lisa to 80. According to legend, what patron saint illustrated the idea of the Holy Trinity by using a shamrock? Lisa?
St. Patrick.
St. Patrick is right. Patron saint of Ireland. And Lisa to 85. A group of soldiers called Hessians fought for England during the American Revolution. From what country did these Hessians, Lisa?
Russia?
No. They came from Germany. First time in a while, Lisa's taken a backward step. She loses five. And now, that third and final fame game and a big $25 money card goes up there. If you're going to catch her, Claire, Cindy, you might need it. We're looking for a famous person. I was born in California in 1913. At age 10, I worked as a bean picker, later as a janitor and amusement park barker. I married Thelma Catherine Ryan, got into politics in 1936, became a congressman, then a senator. I served 8 years as vice president of the U.S. When I ran for president, I was defeated by John F. Kennedy. Cindy.
Richard Nixon.
You are exactly right, yes. He once worked as a bean picker, a janitor, and an amusement park barker. Cindy, where's that $25 money card, Summer?
Nine, the nine.
All right, we're locking in your buzzer now, Cindy, so good luck.
25, 25, 25.
Lands on 15. That might help the cause. If Cindy jumps into second place, we have the $15. She goes to 35. And now we finish up this most important game with a speed round. May I have 60 seconds on the clock, please? It is Lisa at 80, Clay at 30, Cindy at 35, but I've got a lot of questions if you get on a roll. But if Lisa is ahead at the end, she is $50,000 richer. Good luck. We start the speed round now. What common household tool comes in varieties such as claw, ball peen?
Lisa. Hammer.
Right. Which U.S. city has sports teams named the Celtics and Bruins? Lisa.
Boston.
Right. What is the translation of the Spanish word mañana? Lisa.
Tomorrow.
Right. In our solar system, how many planets are known to orbit the sun? Lisa.
Nine.
Right. What famous street is the home of the New York Stock Exchange? Lisa.
Wall Street.
Right. Who was the first U.S. vice president and second president? Clay.
Adams.
Right. In the Armed Forces Parade, what is held by the color bearer? Lisa.
Flag.
Right. What natural stimulant is often found in tea and coffee? Lisa.
Caffeine.
Right. What is the state capital of Alaska? Clay.
Juneau.
Right. What would you wrap around your fingers if you were playing catch cradle? Lisa.
String.
Right. Name the author of Uncle Tom's Cabin. Lisa.
Harriet Beecher Stowe.
Right. Which body organ is treated by a cardiologist? Lisa.
The heart.
Right. Name the Scottish author who wrote the novels Rob Roy and Ivanhoe. Lisa.
Sir Walter Scott.
Right. What city's fashionable West End has an intersection called Piccadilly? Lisa.
London.
Right. Time is up, and Lisa did it big. Wow. Summer's got a suitcase for her, and she has $50,000 in cash on top of everything else. They're giving you a standing ovation out there, Lisa. Congratulations. Way to go. Congratulations, my dear. I know you were nervous about taking the risk, but it paid off. Way to go. Lisa Munoz, $50,000 richer in cash. Congratulations. Cindy, Clay, thank you very much for joining us. We will wrap things up with Lisa and give you that great total that she's gone home with right after this commercial timeout. Congratulations. Back with our champion, Lisa Munoz, and I've got to share something with you. Lisa, if you've been with us over the last couple of weeks, she had a baby recently, and the thing that she wanted the most when she came on here was to make some money to pay the doctor bills, which are still hanging around. Well, she has more than done that, and we are thrilled for Lisa. You've got all the prizes off the board, trip to Hawaii, two sports cars, a lot of artwork, diamond ring, the pool table, which I know you wanted.
Yeah.
Your cash total with the $50,000 plus all the other cash you picked up along the way, your cash total loan is $68,200. And Lisa is leading us with a grand total of $122,551 in cash and prizes. Congratulations.
Oh, thank you.
Three new challenges. We're going to do them all over again next time on Tale of the Century. Bye for now.
Prices for manufacturers suggested retail value and are correct at the time of recording. Sale of the Century stars Jim Perry. This is Jay Stewart speaking. Century is a red scrunch.